Hi guys, this video is made by Privat Reisekonsulent and is all about the local island Maafushi in the Maldives. Maafushi is one of the largest islands in the Maldives. The island of Maafushi is only 27 kilometers away from the main island of Male, and it only takes 1.5 hours to sail by the local ferry from Male to Maafushi. If you are traveling on a budget vacation like us, the local ferry are a great solution, because it only costs $2 per person. It is also possible to rent your own speedboat, but it's very expensive, and a speedboat costs $100 per person. When you arrive at the island of Maafushi with the local boat, your hotel will meet and greet you and take your luggage and take you down to the hotel, so you don't have to run around on the island trying to find your hotel on your own. Even though the island of Maafushi is one of the biggest islands in the Maldives, the island itself is only 1.275 kilometers long and is 260 meters wide. The island is so small that we could walk around it in less than an hour. On the island of Maafushi, there are approximately 3,000 people living all year round. Most of them are local Maldives. So you get a good sense of how the local people live in the Maldives. As most of the country is Muslim, it is also experienced here on this island. And many of the locals walk around in 30 degrees heat with a hijab. On the island, there are no paved roads. There are only a very few cars on the island, so most of the traffic is either by foot, by bicycle or by moped. Because there's no traffic, the atmosphere on the island is very relaxed. And the island seems very unspoiled, and you get an insight into the locals' traditions and lifestyle. The northern part of the island is the tourist area. It is also where the most hotels, restaurants and souvenir shops are located. And it's also at the northern part of the island where you find the best beach, the Bikini Beach. In the middle of the island is the harbor, which is the place where you arrive to the island by ferry or by speedboat. Just opposite the harbor is the school and the administration office of the island. And behind the school there is a stadium and a central mosque. The southern part of the island is the only prison in the Maldives located. The eastern part of the island is mostly uninhabited. A noisy power plant is constantly in action, therefore you live better in the northern part of the Maafushi, although the various guest houses are scattered around the entire island. The island of Maafushi has 6 to 10 hotels, and there are over 46 B&Bs, or guest houses as they call them in the Maldives. We spent 6 days at Maafushi where we stayed at 2 different hotels. The advantage of staying at 2 different hotels on the same island was that we saw the island in 2 different ways because they have 2 different locations. The first hotel we stayed on was located in the middle of the island, and the hotel was called Carney Village and Spa Hotel. It was the only hotel on the island that had a pool. It was a nice hotel with nice rooms, and they had a spa if you would like to pamper yourself. It was a nice breakfast buffet. It was included in the price. The next hotel we stayed on was right at the waterfront, and we had the most stunning view in our room, and that hotel called Carney Beach Hotel. If you plan to stay on Carney Beach, do yourself the favor and order a room with a sea view and a balcony so you can see all the beautiful sunset every night from the room. Moreover, the island's best beach, Bikini Beach, is located right next to the hotel. If you're planning to visit Maafushi, I'll highly recommend both hotels, as they were lovely hotels and we had a fantastic experience on both hotels. Each hotel have their advantages. We paid approximately $100 for a room for 2 people, and that was including breakfast. There are a number of restaurants on Maafushi. There are restaurants in different price ranges on the island. Many of the hotels also have a buffet that is also possible to find. There were also a pizzeria and some local burger bars on the island. And in some places it was possible to sit on the beach and enjoy your dinner while the waves sound in the background. It was a lovely experience. Our favorite restaurant was a bit pricey, but the food also tasted heavenly. Alcohol is forbidden here on this island, as well as other local islands. But close to the island there is a floating bar where you can buy alcoholic beverage. It does not cost anything to get sailed out to the boat and back again, but in return a beer costs $5 and a bottle of vodka $130. What activities can you do on the island? You can walk around the island, it takes less than an hour. Or you can rent a bike and bike around the island. In addition, there are two delicious beaches on the island where you can soak up the sunshine and swim. One is Bikini Beach, where you can wear a bikini. At the public beaches, it's not allowed to swim in a bikini because that's where all the local people swim. But it's okay because the most beautiful beach is Bikini Beach. The Maldives are most famous for its beautiful water, so of course it's possible to do a lot of activities in and above the water. It is possible to do a lot of water sports activities on the water, and there's also a lot of companies selling these activities. And of course, you will also have to go on a few snorkeling trips when you finally come to this paradise. It's an experience for life. Remember to see my separate video about how to save a lot of money on the snorkeling trips that we took from the Maafushi, and I'm also telling you about my three favorite activities in the Maldives. If you haven't planned to spend a few days on a small island where there's only one resort, you can also buy a day trip to one of the nearby resorts, where you are sailed over with a speedboat so you can have lunch on the island and use some of the resort's beaches and pool. So I recommend that if you only have planned to stay in Maafushi on the whole vacation, to do a tour like that. So this was a quick review of the lovely island of Maafushi in the Maldives. Me and my family were very excited about this beautiful island, and I certainly feel that our visit helped us to get an authentic insight into how it is to live in the Maldives. It helped me make my experience of the Maldives complete, as we also chose to visit a magnificent resort, Malahini Kuta Bandas Resort. So don't forget to see my video about this beautiful resort if you're planning to go on a holiday to the Maldives. And don't miss my video about how to travel to the Maldives on a budget holiday. Remember, if you like my video and found my tips helpful, then press the like button down below. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel to get some more helpful and exciting travel tips and advices. As I like to say, to travel is to live, so live your life and plan and book your next vacation now.